cell fluxes. Axilla is, this is axilla. Alright. So axilla has nothing. Axilla is a space. It has an apex, a base, an anterior wall, and posterior wall, and lateral wall, and medial wall, and contents. So this is axilla pyramidal in shape. The base is this. Base is formed by the fascia, skin and fascia. Deep fascia here is called axillary fascia. Apex is upwards. Apex is triangular in shape. It joins with the neck. Apex is bounded by the clavicle, by the superior border of the scapula, and by the outer border of first rib.
Superior border. Posteriorly,
Posteriorly, upper border of scapula. Okay? This is apex, this is base. Now it has four walls. Anterior wall is folded, called the anterior axillary fold. It is formed by pectoralis major, mainly. And under the pectoralis major, by the clavipectoral fascia and two muscles that are enclosed in the clavipectoral fascia. These are pectoralis minor and subclavius. So anterior axillary, anterior wall of axilla or anterior axillary fold is formed by pectoralis major and by clavipectoral fascia and pectoralis minor and subclavius. Posterior axillary wall is also folded. It is called posterior axillary fold. It is formed by subscapularis and latissimus dorsi anterior major. Now, medial wall is, this is medial wall. Medial wall is formed by the upper four ribs with their intercostal spaces and upper part of serratus anterior muscle. Medial wall is this. Medial wall is formed by the upper four ribs with their intercostal spaces and upper part of serratus. You know, serratus anterior muscle was here.
Yes.
It was coming from where? You know. It was going where? You know. Lateral wall is this. Lateral wall of axilla must be formed. Lateral wall of axilla must be formed by upper part of shaft of humerus, that part having bicipital groove and short at the biceps and coracobrachialis. So apex and base and valve of the axilla, this nothing clear?
The lateral is just the upper shaft of the...
Yes, lateral wall is formed, this is. What is this here? What is upper this shaft, lateral wall?
Biceps brachii.
This is formed by the upper part of shaft of humerus and short head of biceps brachii and coracobrachialis. Yes, biceps brachii. Biceps femoris is here. Biceps brachii. Okay?
Okay.
Clear? Yes. What are the contents of axilla? So here, there must be nerves, there must be arteries, there must be veins, there must be lymphatics, there must be... These are the contents.
Yes.
So contents are nerves here. Yes.
Want some contents?
Contents are one plexus of nerves called the brachial plexus. And what else? An artery here?
Axillary
artery. A vein here?
Axillary.
And lymph nodes here?
Class? The medial cord in the sheath.
Yes.
Is the axillary artery inside the sheath. Axillary sheath or outside?
The artery is inside.
The artery.
The vein. Initially it's inside, but it can deviate and takes out, right?
Yes. Axillary vein is outside.
Axillary vein from the stump.
Inside. Initially it's inside.
Vein outside.
All of them are inside initially.
Yes.
The vein takes out.
You know, what is... What is the job of axillary sheath?
Protection and
expansion. You know, near every major vein, there is a dead space, there is an empty space. Why?
For dilation.
To make the dilatation of the vein available. To give the space for the dilatation of the vein in times of increased blood flow. Like we have carotid sheath here, we have femoral sheath here, we have axillary sheath here. So axillary artery is in the axilla. You know everything about, we will not talk about axillary artery. We will talk about the brachial plexus. Okay? Axillary artery, axillary vein, everything, axillary roots, you know. Brachial plexus. What is brachial plexus? Brachial plexus is
network.
Brachial plexus is a plexus of nerves. How it is formed? It is formed by the ventral rami of lower four cervical upper one thoracic. Or you can say it is formed by the union of ventral rami of C5, 6, 7, 8 and T1. Sometimes C4 contributes, then it is called prefixed type of plexus. Sometimes T2 includes cause post-fixed type of plexus. So in the formation of brachial plexus, these are these five roots, then roots become trunks, trunks then divides, divisions, then cord, then branches. The roots are located between the scalenae muscles. Trunks in the posterior triangle of the neck, divisions behind the clavicle, cord in the axilla, and branches in the upper limb. Okay. So upper limb is supplied by the branches from the brachial plexus. So we are, how these are formed? Brachial plexus, in 2 minutes short, we will talk about theory of brachial plexus, then I will show you. Brachial plexus is this.
Roots. Can we help with that?
With
drawing
color?
With you.
Eh?
Drawing with you can.
Can you draw?
Yes.
Other color?
There is another color.
Where? Okay.
Do
you want to draw?
Okay.
If any mistake, then.
This one is anterior, posterior. No, it's posterior anterior.
Okay.
The first posteriors will unite together, to give the lateral cord, the all posteriors, and this one will give me the medial cord, and all posteriors will unite to form the posterior cord, which is here, giving the posterior cord. Starting with the lateral cord will give me two, one in here for the lateral pectoral nerve.
Yes.
فاهمين كلامنا ولا لا؟ محاضرتين اليوم سالي خلي الدكتور السيري
طيب ايه رايكم نتفقوا عليه؟
ها؟
شباب شباب اللي يبغاها اليوم يرفع يده تكفون.
ايوه برافو عليك انا حلاها.
طيب هذول اثنين واللي يبغون اسمع الجاي.
ما في الاسبوع
الجاي
امتى؟
كلهم كان في الموضوع ما في شيء.
في العادي يكون بريك ما يكونش فيه اي حاجه الساعه 12 قبلها حد يبلغنا
اليوم. هو كم عاوز يا دكتور؟
الاسبوع الجاي مليان مليان برامج مليان ليكتشرز
في ستيل
كم يحتاج يا دكتور؟
خلاص
انا اقول الحين يعني وين المشكله هذه؟
الاسبوع الجاي
انتم حاضرين انا
تصويت خلاص
دكتاتورية. والله لا بد الدكتاتورية بالمجال.
لا
خلاص
طب دكتور انت
خلاص بص انا في الحضور هناك
خلاص متى انا
اتفقوا وحدي بس
ان شاء الله.
شكرا
دكتور.
هذا
في هذا
طيب
استنى تشرفوا ذا
but he has BBL now
so then then
So this is, you know, the brachial plexus is this. This is the roots. Upper trunk is from, you know, right? C5, C6. Middle trunk and lower trunk. Lower trunk is C8 and D1. Inner cord. The anterior posterior division. Lateral cord is formed by the union of anterior division of upper and middle trunk.
Yes.
And posterior cord is formed by the union of posterior division of all the three trunks.
Yes.
And medial cord is formed by the post anterior division of the lower trunk. Yes. It's clear. Yes. Now the branches are the brachial plexus. Okay. Branches from the roots. Branches, now we are considering those branches which supply the upper limb. Actually, there are two other branches, we are not concerned about this. So these branches from the roots are two branches, long thoracic nerve and dorsal scapular nerve. Yes. Long thoracic nerve is C5, 6, 7. Long thoracic nerve is for the serratus anterior. Yes.
Class.
Long. Okay. Serratus anterior. Other is dorsal scapular nerve.
From the root.
This is
C5.
Dorsal scapular nerve. C5. Other name is nerve to rhomboids. It is for three muscles, levator, scapular, rhomboides, minor, rhomboides, major. Class?
To rhomboides and?
Levator, scapulae.
Doctor.
Those three muscles which are inserted on the dorsal aspect of medial border effect of scapula. This is levator, scapulae, rhomboides, minor, and rhomboides, major.
True.
These three muscles are supplied with the dorsal scapular nerve or nerve to rhomboid from the roots from the C5. Clear?
No, clear.
Any confusion?
No, clear.
No. Okay. Now the branches from the trunks.
Right.
So there are branches from the upper trunk only. There's no branch from the middle trunk and lower trunk. And from the upper trunk, there are only two branches. One in nerve to subclavius. This nerve to subclavius supply only one muscle. What is the name of that muscle?
Subclavius.
Plus, now suprascapular nerve supply two muscles. Supraspinatus and infraspinatus. Supraspinatus and infraspinatus. So nerve to subclavius and suprascapular nerve root value is C5, 6.
Again.
C5, 6.
Yes.
So up from the trunk, there are two branches from upper trunk, nerve to subclavius and suprascapular nerve. For subclavius, for supraspinatus and infraspinatus. Plus. Now we come on branches from the cords. There are three branches from the lateral cord, 5 from the medial, 5 from the posterior. Three branches from the lateral cord are lateral pectoral nerve, lateral root of median nerve, and musculocutaneous nerve. Lateral pectoral nerve supplies pectoral is major muscle. But, yes.
That's it. And comes from C567. That's true, huh? That's true.
Lateral pectoral nerve supply pectoralis major muscle, but it gives also some fibers to pectoralis minor muscle. Medial. Lateral root of median nerve. We'll talk about later on. Third is musculocutaneous nerve is the continuation of the lateral cord of brachial plexus. Why it is called musculocutaneous? Because it is muscular in the arm and cutaneous in the forearm. It is muscular in the arm for three muscles. Those three muscles are BBC, brachialis, biceps and coracobrachialis. And it is cutaneous for the forearm. In the forearm, its name is lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm, and it supplies skin of the lateral side of the forearm. So musculocutaneous nerve is the continuation of lateral cord of brachial plexus. It pierces the coracobrachialis muscle. That it inclines laterally. Then near the insertion of tendon of biceps, it pierces the deep fascia, becomes superficial, runs in the superficial fascia of the lateral side of the forearm as a lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm. So musculocutaneous nerve is musculocutaneous nerve is muscular for the arm and cutaneous for the forearm, and it supplies only three muscles, that are BBC. Class?
Yes.
BBC. Now we come on medial cord of brachial plexus. No question? No question.
BBC.
Yes.
BBC.
BBC.
Brachial.
Brachial.
Bicep.
Coracobrachialis.
How are the BBC entertaining?
BBC are three muscles in the anterior compartment of the arm. These BBC are brachialis,
biceps,
and coracobrachialis. These BBC are supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve, except small lateral part of brachialis that is supplied by the radial nerve. The question is, radial nerve is the nerve of posterior compartment. Why the radial nerve supply a part of brachialis? That is the muscle of anterior compartment. Radial nerve is not a nerve of anterior compartment. The answer is that the nerve supply of any structure tells the story of its development. So in the embryology, in the prenatal development, brachialis muscle part was present. It developed in the posterior compartment of the arm. Now, the branches from the medial cord of brachial plexus. There are five branches from the medial cord of brachial plexus. These five branches are medial pectoral nerve that supplies pectoralis major and pectoralis minor. And medial cutaneous nerve of arm that supplies skin of the medial side of the arm. And medial cutaneous nerve of the forearm that supply skin of the medial side of the forearm, and medial root of median nerve, and the continuation of the medial cord is
ulnar.
Ulnar nerve is the continuation of the medial cord of brachial plexus. Root value is C81. That some fibers may come from C7. So root value is C81, as you can write C781, okay, both correct. So ulnar nerve runs in the medial side of anterior compartment of the arm, then it inclines, passes behind the medial epicondy of the humerus, then comes forward, then it passes between, then it pierces flexor carpi ulnaris, then runs here, and in the it give no branches in the arm. No, ulnar nerve give no branches in the arm. It supplies 1.5 muscles in the forearm. That 1.5 muscles are flexor carpi ulnaris and medial half of flexor digitorum profundus. And then it enters into the palm by passing over the flexor retinaculum. Then it supplies 15 out of the 20 muscles of the palm. No posterior. There is cutaneous supply. But at this, okay, you want cutaneous supply of the head?
No.
In muscles, ulnar supply, you know, axial goodies. This is dorsum of hand, this is palm. In the dorsum of hand, there is no intrinsic muscle. Question khalas. In palm of hand, there are 20 muscles. Three muscles of thinaremins, three muscles of hypothinaremins, and palmaris brevis, and adductor pollicis, and four lumbricals, and four palm introsei, and four dorsal introsei. Out of 20 muscles, 5 are supplied by the median, and 15 are supplied by the About the you interested about the cotinus supply, okay. Cotinus supply, we'll tell you later on. This is hand. Now, cotinus supply of, you will divide medial one and half and lateral one and half. In palmar surface, lateral one and half, fingers and lateral side of the palm is supplied by the median nerve. And lateral and left and medial one and half, fingers by the ulnar. On the dorsal aspect, lateral one, lateral three and half by the radial, and medial one and half by the ulnar. So cutaneous nerve supply of the ulnar nerve in the palm is medial one and half fingers and medial side of the hand, both palmar aspect and dorsal aspect. Okay? Okay, you get it. So this is, it also gives branches to the joint, to this elbow joint and to the wrist joint, but muscles, it supplies one and half muscles of the end, of the anterior compartment of the forearm, and 15 muscles of the palm. Now this is lateral root of median nerve and medial root of median nerve. Both join to form the median nerve. So root value of median nerve must be C5, 6, 7, 8, and T1.
Yes.
Median nerve is all formed by these two roots and then me. Yes, all.
All posterior.
Yes.
All
yes.
Origins.
Yes.
So it's on radial.
Yes. Yes. You're right. So median nerve. Then from here it climbs laterally. And then it runs in the anterior compartment of the R. It gives no branches in the R. Then it enters into the cubital fossa. Then it passes between the two heads of pronator teres. What is pronator? We will tell you next week. And then median nerve divides into a superficial branch and a deep branch. So deep branch is called the anterior interosseous nerve, and superficial branch and median nerve supplies 6.5 muscles out of 8 in the anterior compartment of the forearm. That it enters into the palm by passing under the flexor retina culum and then enters into the palm, and in the palm it supplies 5 muscles in the palm and palmar aspect of lateral 3.5 fingers skin. Clear? Very clear? Very clear. Very clear? Very clear. Now we come on branches from the posterior cord of brachial plexus. From the posterior cord of brachial plexus, there are only 5 branches.
Yes.
Upper subscapular, thoracic, dorsal, lower subscapular, axillary, radial. So these are very easy. These are very easy. Okay. Upper
subscapular.
Eh? Okay. Upper subscapular nerve.
And the last one is
lower subscapular.
Thoracodorsal nerve. Lower subscapular nerve, axillary nerve, and continuation
radial.
If
choracial.
Radial. Upper subscapular nerve supply which muscle?
Huh?
Again.
Upper subscapular nerve supply? Subscapular. Thoracodorsal nerve supply? Latissimus dorsi. And lower subscapular nerve supply? Subscapularis anteris major, very good. And axillary nerve supplies, deltoid anteris minor, very good. And radial nerve supplies, radial, again, okay, again. Upper subscapular nerve supplies, subscapularis. Thoracodorsal nerve supply, latissimus dorsi. Lower subscapular nerve supplies, subscapularis anteris major. Axillary nerve supply, deltoid anteris minor. And radial nerve supply?
Yes.
Okay. Radial nerve is a continuation of posterior cord of brachial plexus its root value is C5, 6, 7, 8 NT1. And radial nerve then passes in the radial groove, runs in the radial groove.
Spiral
groove with the profunda brachii vessels from medial to lateral side in the middle 1/3 of posterior aspect of the arm. Then radial nerve comes here, then here it passes in front of lateral epicondyle, then the radial nerve pierces the supinator muscle, then in the upper part of forearm it divides into superficial branch and deep branch. Deep branch is called posterior interosseous nerve that runs on the posterior aspect of interosseous membrane and supplies the muscles of deep group of the posterior compartment of forearm. And superficial is a smaller branch that supplies the muscles of superficial group of posterior compartment of forearm. And then in here it becomes cutaneous. It supplies skin of the lateral side of dorsum of hand and dorsal surface of lateral 3.5 fingers.
Yeah, the parts is supplied by what?
Ulnar. I said this one is ulnar.
It's the cutaneous.
So to make very easy, the nerve supply of upper limb is very, very easy. So this is nerve supply. Yeah? Anterior compartment of arm, all muscles supplied by the musculocutaneous nerve. Posterior compartment of arm, all muscles supplied by the radial nerve.
Yes.
Plus, posterior compartment of forearm, all muscles are supplied by the radial nerve. There are 20 muscles here, all supplied by the radial nerve. Anterior compartment of forearm. Here, 12 muscles, all supplied by the radial nerve. And anterior compartment of forearm, 8 muscles. All are supplied by the median nerve. Only 1.5 are supplied by the ulnar nerve. Which 1.5? Flexor carpi ulnaris and medial half of flexor digitorum profundus. In the palm, there are 20 muscles. All are supplied by?
Ulnar nerve.
Except 5 muscles. Which 5 muscles? First two lumbricals and 3 muscles are thinner eminence.
Awesome.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay.
Okay.
These 1.5 by median nerve. By ulnar nerve. Which 1.5? Flexor carpi ulnaris and flexor digitorum profundus. Median nerve. It means in the anterior compartment of the forearm there are 8 muscles, all are supplied by the median nerve, only 1.5 are supplied by the ulnar nerve. It means that 6.5 are supplied by the median nerve, 1.5 are supplied by the ulnar nerve. So 1.5 is a short. If you remember this 1.5, which 1.5 are supplied by the ulnar nerve? Flexor carpi ulnaris and medial half of flexor digitorum profundus. In the palm, there are 20 muscles. All are supplied by the ulna. It means 15 are supplied by the ulna and 5 are supplied by the median nerve. Which 5 by the median nerve? 3 muscles of thinar eminence. And first 2 lumbricals. These 5 muscles are supplied by the median nerve. All the other 15 muscles are supplied by the
ulna.
Yes.
It's hard to understand this.
Hard, okay.
Because we didn't get the muscles yet.
Yes. Okay, okay. But you understand that here all muscles by the ulna except 5. Here all muscles are median except 1.5. Here all muscles are radial. Here all muscles by the radial. Here all muscles by the muscle proteins. Now easy? Next week I will tell you in which muscles are supplied by the radial nerve directly, which muscles by the posterior interosseous branch of the radial nerve.
So only the task memorize only the nerve and supply. We should know the muscle, then know what's
then
the supply.
The nerve supply.
But this is, you know, posterior compartment, all by the radial.
Yes.
Anterior compartment, musculocutaneous, medial, ulnar. What is the problem? Posterior compartment, radial, radial. Anterior, musculocutaneous, medium, ulna. Here, except ulna, except ulna. Okay? So this is radial. Musculocutaneous, medium, ulna. Any problem?
The posterior, the radial.
Radial.
The
musculocutaneous, medium, ulna. Any problem? Easy?
And the palm, 50 muscles are from the ulna. And flat from the
now we show the brachial plexus and axilla.
Done.
First, attendant Badal. See, students here and here. All. You start from here. You start from here.
Okay. Which nerve is this? It is very easy.
Radio
nerve.
Which nerve is this?
Ulnar nerve.
Ulnar
nerve.
Why ulnar nerve?
Because it's supplied by
the posterior.
Because it is passing just behind the middle epicondyle. This is middle epicondyle. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Which nerve is this?
It's radial.
Radial. No.
Haula bula.
No, 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 muscular.
Muscular.
Medial, medial.
Okay, medial.
Medial.
Median nerve. You know, it is going in the cubital fossa.
How to know it?
And
tell us, you know, how to know that.
I'm telling you this. I'm telling you this. I'm telling the same asking before completing my sentence. I'm telling you this. Listen carefully. So this is median nerve.
Okay.
So it is in the cubital fossa.
Okay.
It's passing between the two heads of pronator teres. It's the main nerve of this here. Median nerve. This is ulnar nerve.
Just behind the posterior.
Which nerve must be this? This.
Radial.
This radial nerve.
Uh-huh,
yeah. Why radial? Because
it
this
supplies all the posterior.
Anterior.
It is coming in the posterior compartment in the radial groove.
Radial.
Radial. This is radial nerve here. Here it is coming in front of lateral epicondyle. Radial nerve. And what else? Musculocutaneous. We will this is
corticobulanus.
This is musculocutaneous nerve. Why musculocutaneous? Because this nerve is piercing coracobrachialis.
What is
this? This is coracobrachialis. This is shorted biceps. Coracobrachialis. So this is piercing coracobrachialis. Coracobrachial insertion here. Original coracoid process. So this is which nerve?
Musculocutaneous.
No muscles. Which muscle is this?
Subscapularis.
Which muscle is this?
Tris major.
Which muscle is this? Latissimus. Which muscle is this?
Minor.
Biceps. This is short at the biceps. Right. Long head is passing in the bicipital groove. It is coming from the supraglenoid tubercle. Short head is coming from the coracoid process with the coracobrachialis. So this is short at the biceps. Okay? Easy?
Okay.
Very easy. Now come on this. Same thing.
Where's the brachialis? Nothing.
This is medial wall of axilla. This is upper ribs with intercostal spaces. This is lateral wall of axilla. This upper part of humerus and short head of biceps and coracobrachialis. And this is anterior wall is this pectoralis major. And posterior wall is this. Teres major, latissimus dorsi, and subscapularis will come here. This is subscapularis.
And anterior wall is what?
This is subscapularis. And this is apex. This is clavicle.
And boundaries?
This is clavicle, and this is scapula. And here is the first rib. Here is first rib. So this is apex. Here is the first rib. Here is clavicle. Here is scapula.
This anterior.
Anterior boundary of the apex is formed by the clavicle. Posterior boundary is formed by the upper border of the scapula. Medial boundary is formed by the outer border of the first rib. All this triangular in shape. You can see this is the first rib. This is the first rib.
You should write it in the exam. We didn't get anything. Sorry.
It's so easy. This for the practice. So this apex. This is clavicle. No, I'm telling you very easy thing. But when you ask difficult thing, then what I can do?
It's very easy.
No, I'm telling you in very easy way. But you want, I think, difficult way. This is
clavicle.
And this is scapula. And this is. This is brachial plexus. Okay. You know this nerve, this is going, you know, here.
Piercing?
This is going here. So this is radial nerve. Mm-hmm. But here it's not completely came here, visible here. And
can you recognize it, sir?
This muscle, this nerve is correct musculocutaneous. Because piercing. It is piercing coracobrachialis. And this nerve is must be
The median nerve.
And this nerve must be the ulnar nerve. Yeah. Because it is this medial epicondyle behind this. Yes.
Antecubital?
No, okay.
No. Below the epicondyle.
Behind. I told you humerus that three nerves are directly related to the humerus. I told you that the ulnar nerve passes behind the medial epicondyle of humerus, and I told you that in supracondylar fracture, ulnar nerve may be injured. It may result in paralysis of intrinsic muscles of the palm if it result in claw hand. And I told you that.
What's that here? Okay.
So these are the nerves. Now come on here. Which nerve is this?
Median
nerve.
Which nerve is this?
On the nerve.
Musculocutaneous.
Radial
nerve. Which nerve must be here?
Radial nerve.
And musculocutaneous. Piercing the. This is coracobrachialis. Any nerve piercing it?
كرة كبرتيها لستسوى
We cannot see clearly masculinity now here.
Inside.
Usually which nerves we ask? We usually we ask median nerve, ulnar nerve or radial nerve.
Yeah, please, stick on this.
Come on this, here.
I can hear. Yeah.
Oh. Which nerve is this?
Median nerve.
Median nerve. Okay. We can't see it.
So don't bring it to the exam, huh?
What's going
to be? Here, here,
here. Which nerve
this
must
one
be?
Is to be conda-
this, which nerve?
We can't see
this. It is going behind. It is going behind. It is going behind. It is going behind. It is going behind.
Radial.
Radial. And this is coracobrachialis. 1 minute.
This one, this one.
This is coracobrachialis. This muscle. An inner piercing it.
This one.
This is musculocutaneous.
Yeah.
This is musculocutaneous. Going in the coracobrachialis. And this is median. And
ulnar.
And this is radial.
Where is musculocutaneous?
And this is this. This musculocutaneous. This is musculocutaneous.
There is muscle.
Yes. This is radial and this is axillary.
How can I differentiate coracobrachialis muscle?
It's very, very easy. If you see two muscles
between
coming...
Between the triceps and the biceps, right? Just
now, this one is the bicep.
This is coracobrachialis.
Behind the short head of the bicep.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
This is yes or no?
Yes. This... Which nerve is this?
Ulnar.
Yes. Which muscle is this? This? This?
Abductor spinal. No.
Which is this? Which is this?
Major.
Which is this?
Biceps.
Short head.
Which is this?
Coracobrachialis.
Very good. Yes. Very good. Now, okay. Which muscle is this?
Where?
Which nerve is this?
Where?
This nerve. Median. Yeah. Other nerves we can't see because no piercing it. We can see. Which nerve is this? This is going behind. This
radial.
Radial. Okay. Come on this. Which muscle is this?
Where?
Hazi.
Where?
Extralis minor.
This muscle.
Square?
Subscribe. And this muscle?
Sinus anterior.
Certainly. Okay.
No. How
this is subscapularis. Okay. Which muscle is this?
Shorter
biceps. This is longer biceps. And this is coracobrachialis. Okay?
Yes.
And this nerve piercing the coracobrachialis, this nerve is musculocutaneous. And this nerve going behind, you know, this is going behind here. This nerve. Radial nerve. And this nerve.
This nerve is supposed to be
median nerve. And this nerve.
What is
this?
Easy.
Where
is this one here?
This
muscle?
This muscle? I don't know.
You can
dance? Why not?
Next week.
No, this is biceps.
Biceps.
Oh.
Same muscle.
Yeah.
Any questions?
Thank you.
Attendance. This is not median.
This
muscle, brachialis. Brachialis.
No.
Excuse me, Mr. Where is the ulnar nerve?
This is Al-Nanar.
Comedian.
This is Al-Nanar. This is Al-Nanar. This is Al-Nanar. Vishnu.
Al-Nanar.
This is Al-Nanar. Shouting for the last 10 minutes. Al-Nanar. This is
the median.
This is median.
Yes, it's median.
This is
median. That's what I say.
Yes. Attendance. Ahmed. Attendance.
Hey, shit, Ale.
By the way, we don't have attendance sheet.
So you write F on, you know, on
doctor. Attendance sheet.
Yes, sir, what is it?
This is me
sheet.
Sheet. اسبر اسبر. فرق بين الميديا والبرانش.
لا لا لا.
شا.
انا حاضر.